Yes, everybody, welcome to a brand new day, a brand new day's podcast. I'm going to talk about a certain topic today that I want to dig deep about bloopers, outtakes, and raw footage to raw audio to you name it. This is all have to do with the movie industry. This is stuff that never gets aired on big major films to TV shows to videos sometimes on YouTube. Sometimes it's bloopers, outtakes. Outtakes means it's like deleted scenes. It's like sort of like deleted scenes. Stuff that never gets aired on the final product, final video. And these are just outtakes, bloopers. We want to keep you people entertained. The whole notion of entertain is either through bloopers, through a full film, to you name it. So we're going to talk about the whole scenario. It could mean TV shows, movies, big feature film, films, to just audio stuff. That this is just bloopers, stuff that you want to be entertained. That's why us YouTubers, creators out there want to create that so-called entertainment sort of value out of the videos or audio, whatever the case may be. So we want to make it entertained. So the way we do it is through audio, video, and we do it through bloopers, outtakes, and raw footage to raw audio, to everything, just the stuff that you people don't tend to see in big major theaters, big major featurealistic films. And this was kind of like left off of the cutting room floors. This is bloopers, outtakes that you can make mistakes about. Sometimes you have a little, you kind of laugh at yourself. Sometimes you do outtakes and you can put a little laughter in it. And these are what you call bloopers, outtakes, and raw footage, raw audio. This is stuff that were left off of a big major film. Sometimes people do couple of takes until they get it right. They want to do it perfectionally. They want to get it right the first time. They always want to get it right the first time when you're doing big major films. A big film company comes along, does a big major film, and all they want to do, sometimes with big major films, they usually do a couple of takes before they get it right. They want a perfection on the actual futuristic film, TV shows, to you name it. They want to really hammer it down to have it right. So as a viewer, you don't get the bloopers, you don't get the outtakes, you don't get raw footage, you don't get the raw audio, and stuff that wasn't even edited out. Stuff that just nearly gets it edited out. The bloopers get edited out a lot on TV shows and big major films. Tons of it. Usually they're not on the final product. They're not on the final product when you see on the theaters. Half of it is all the blooper stuff side of things. And the outtakes. The outtakes means they do outtakes of takes and takes of the film until they get it right. So I'm going to give you a definition with bloopers and outtakes and raw footage to raw audio. Raw audio, if you guys don't know, is just like unedited, just pure raw audio. Not been tampered with, is no tampering with the audio is what they say with raw audio. It's right from the camera lens, right off the microphone, unedited. That's the raw audio. That's what you call raw audio. Nothing's been tampered with the audio. It's just pure audio from your voice to your microphone to on this recording device. That's the raw audio. But if you want to go on a computer and do all the, as they say, post-production or pre-production, then you do all that on your computer. You can do a lot of effectsing. You can do a lot of effects on your audio. You can do all sorts of stuff with audio. You can manipulate the audio. I mean, people done this in the past. Manipulate the audio. In terms of having a kid's voice to a manly voice. If you're recording something on a computer and you want to do effects to your voice, you want to change your effects to your voice, once it goes through a microphone and through a processor, audio processor, and you can change the effects out of it, then you get different effects. You get pitch control. They call it pitching control, where you can change a person's voice. When it comes out to your mouth to the microphone, from the microphone to the sound mixer, you can change wherever you need to with your voice. Have it sound like a manly voice to a kid's voice, to whatever you wanted. That's the effects part. That's called pitching it. You can pitch the sound and make it sound like a manly voice and not a kid's voice. And that lies with that sometimes. Sometimes it works to advantages. And it works for a lot of purposes. They call it a lot of purposes. Doing that is great. It's great because you can change your own voice. It's not like your normal voice. That's where editing comes available. And that's where the effects comes available. So I'm going to talk about that. The raw audio is where from your mouth, from the microphone, through the mixer, through the recording, that's all live. That's just raw audio, pure raw audio without the effects and the pitching to it. That's just pure raw audio. But when you do it post-productions, and you have a soundboard, a mixing board that would have effects in it and it could change your voice with, that's called pitching. You can pitch your voice and make it sound manly voice to a kid's voice. And really sound really, with a kid's voice, usually it sounds enthusiastic. It sounds really enthusiastic in a kid's voice. But a manly voice sounds really deep. It sounds like a deep, deep voice in a manly's voice. It sounds very manly, as they would say. It's a deep voice. They pitched it down to where it sounds like a manly voice. So folks, that's the way the role works. And I want to talk about this certain topic because I haven't talked about it previous. So if you want to talk about audio, we talk about raw audio, raw footage. Footage is like raw footage right from the camera lens, right from the tape that you recorded on. That's the raw footage without editing out anything. From what the camera sees to what the stuff you recorded on the camera, that's the raw footage. That's pure raw footage. It hasn't gone to an edited software. It's just sometimes when you see live streaming videos, that's one take and one take only. There's no several takes on the audio or the video. It's just one live stream. And you only get one chance in the live stream. You screw up, you say whoops, something, that's in the video. That's totally in the video kind of thing. And that's what you call a live stream. It's one take live stream kind of thing. So if you screw up, so usually I highly recommend to anybody who's doing live streams on YouTube or anything on social media, always practice before you go on a live stream. Always practice it before you go on a live stream. Just practice it. Practice what you need to say on a live stream, then you'll know what to do on a live stream. It's very hard. I know people have trouble about this, but I'm just saying, when you do a live stream, always practice beforehand, as they call it, beforehand, before you do your live stream, so nothing will go wrong. Always do like a preview screen. Practice it. Make sure your audio is in check. Make sure your video is still there, and it records that video on a live stream. And that's what you do on a preview screen. You check all your audio, check if everything's A-OK, it checks out kind of thing. And that's what you do on a preview screen. Before you start doing the live stream, make sure everything is in good working order before you do the live streaming, like right off the live streaming. So the people, when people see it, they see a smooth video going on and live audio is sounding really good. That's where that comes from. So folks, that's where the live stream. So always keep this in mind. Always practice it before you go live stream. Some people don't do it, but that's okay. But if you don't know how to do a live stream as good as you wanted to, always practice it. Always practice beforehand. Before you jump into doing a live stream, practice it before. Do it like a preview screen. And practice, make sure the audio is in check. Make sure it sounds good. Make sure the video is all there. Make sure the camera's in right positions to your green screen. Sometimes, if you want, you can use a green screen or a background photo. Many apps today use so-called background images for your video stuff. And it's not always a green screen. You can reuse a green screen, but on some of the apps, sometimes they'll give you a capability of doing like background images of your own videos. And that's, sometimes it comes in handy with that. And just tell your viewers you're using a green screen to a background image. You from the camera. Just let them know. And you can do this in many live stream videos and pre-recorded videos too as well. I'm just giving you guys hints on that stuff. But when you're doing live streams, always practice it before you go doing live streams, before you get on to live streaming the thing. Always make sure the audio is all there. Make sure the camera is positioned properly. Make sure you have the video going properly. Making sure everything is like, it's like the check mark of check marks. And always do that. You can always practice this, people, before you do a live stream. Because people like to rush to judgment when they do live streaming. They don't know if the sound sounds good. They don't know if the video is all there. They don't have the right camera position, right lighting system. I always forgot about that. Right lighting system. Always practice this beforehand. I know it takes a bit of time, but in the long run, the videos will turn out nice, people. This is what I'm hammering to you people out there. Your videos will turn out very nice. People make comments on your videos saying, that's a nice video we have there on the live stream. They will come appreciate your live streams. So if you can take the time, do a previous screen, practice it, you'll get better. And then when it comes to time of you doing a live stream, have the camera positioned properly, have the audio working properly. It's like doing check marks. It's like doing a check mark on a little notepad saying everything's checked off. Audio sounds good. The camera angle is good. Lighting is good. We'll check the audio. Make sure the audio is clear enough so the viewers out there can hear you properly. Camera in a good position. The lighting system is in a good position. Just practice this beforehand. Don't rush into your live streams and not knowing that this is all perfect and everything. Just making sure everything is like a check mark. It's like putting check marks on your notepad. Putting all the check marks in a box kind of thing. Making sure you have the right lighting system. Make sure you have the right camera position. And so on and so forth. Make sure your mic's on. It's not muted or anything. Make sure it has a good level signal. All that is coming to factors, folks. Just bear that in mind. Make sure things will have these so-called auto, sometimes with, apps, sometimes they'll have a function called the auto. Usually with audio, you can always put in an auto mode. It'll set the levels on itself. You only just the levels itself. You can put it in auto mode, and it'll set the volume of the microphone in level. So that's quite good. That's quite good, folks. So remember that if there's available on the equipment that says auto for the audioing, then leave it at that, because that'll set the microphone levels on its own. So you don't have to do anything. It just sets itself for the audio levels. If you can do that on, sometimes they'll have functions like that on a live broadcast. Always make sure your microphone is always on when you're doing a live broadcast. Always do like a practice run before you know for sure this is going to sound good. Always do it before you start the live stream. Make sure the viewers can hear it. Make sure, the lighting is good on the camera. Make sure the camera's in the right good position. Make sure the audio is good so the viewers out there can hear you okay. It's like a big check mark on a list of things that might go wrong, should go wrong in a live stream. Just remember that, folks, don't rush to judge. Just do it. I know it's tedious for a lot of people, but do this, practice this before you go on a live stream, before you do a live stream on a YouTube, to any social media site. Just practice this. Promise me, people. Just practice this. You'll get better in time, they would say. Better in time of these videos. So just practice this. I know people say it's tedious, but the live streams might be good. So just hear me out on this, folks. So like I said, bloopers, outtakes and live raw audios. And by the way, folks, if you're doing live streams on your YouTube channels, this is just highly recommended for all you people out there. Practice it before you go on live streams. Always make sure you have cameras on. Make sure you have your audio good. Say really good, thumbs up. Make sure the viewer knows that it's good, sounds good audio coming from the live streams. Always test this stuff out. This is what I'm saying to you people out there. Always test things out before you start getting the live stream going. So always make sure, do that. It's like a check mark in the box kind of thing. And just be sure, but some software, sometimes it allows you to do the mic on an audio level, like auto level. So you don't have to adjust anything, it adjusts itself for the audio level. And it works out fine. So folks, try and practice this before you do live streams. Today we're just talking about bloopers, outtakes, raw audio to raw footage, a whole sorts of stuff. So this is just bloopers, outtakes on films and audio. People like to laugh, be entertained. The whole word, the whole notion is being entertained. You want to be entertained to these people out there on YouTube and Twitch and everything. And yeah, so folks, bear this in mind. Just practice this and you'll get better in time. People appreciate your live streams a lot. I mean, pretty much a lot. If you want to use a green screen, go by all means use a green screen. Or if you want to do a background image, you could use a background image if it's available. If it's not, then don't worry about it. Just use a wall, a big canvas wall, like a white wall. That would be great. You can use that as like a green screen and stuff. Just a plain wall will do for anybody who wants to use the background of something. Just bear this in mind. Just remember this, folks. When you're doing live stream video out there, practice beforehand. If you can't do that, then just practice it before you go and do live streaming. You're anxious to do a live stream. Just practice this. I promise, I know it's tedious for a lot of people out there, but practice beforehand, before you go on to do a live stream and you're rushing to it. Just make sure you have the camera angle right. Make sure you have the lighting system right. Make sure your audio's okay. The viewers can see you okay. So remember this before you do live streams. Make sure you have the cameras on. Make sure you have the mics on. Make sure the video's okay. Make sure the other people can hear you okay. Just do all the check marks in a box. And people would appreciate you a lot more. Say, hey, that live stream of yours was great. Was wonderful. Audio was good. The video was good. The lighting system was good. You did a good job on the live stream. Just people would thank you. A lot of people out there will probably thank you for it, for doing the live stream. Just make sure you have the right camera angles, right lighting system. If you need to do a continuous lighting system, that's great. If you afford to do that, you can always use any light system you can, as long as it's lit, as long as it's bright enough for the camera can see the person on the video. It's not like dark, like way dark. You need to have a light in your camera to see the person. If it's day like this, you might not need a lighting system. But when it's dark, like really dark, when the sun goes down and it's all dark around the areas, then you might need a lighting system of some sort on the camera. Because it needs to see the thing in front of it to see, to actually see. It's like a camera's only like the third eye. It sees what it wants to see, but it can't see unless it needs a light. These are cameras with low lighted systems. I don't know why, but they apparently are. So some cameras come with built-in lighting system. Some cameras come with built-in lighting system. That's great. That's wonderful. If it does, that's great. That's wonderful. And just set it to auto. Set everything to auto. You won't go wrong with anything. They'll know what to do. Trust me. Just set everything on your settings to auto on your camera, and you won't go wrong with it. That's great. And if you want, you can always go to manual on your camera. So bear that in mind, folks. But my recommendation for anybody using a video camera out there in the world, to an iOS device to to an Android device, just bear with me, folks. Just set everything to auto, and if you want to go manual, there's another option of that going manual. You can always set everything in manual to really get a good picture, video picture. So it's not blurry. It's not blurry or anything. So yeah, really, really, I want to help you guys very strongly. I highly recommend this for you folks. Really, truly do. And yeah, so you might get better live streams out there. Just remember, practice it before. Do like a check mark, a checklist of all things that could go wrong, might go wrong on a live stream. You don't want that to happen on a live stream. I'm saying to you people out there, on a live stream, make sure you practice before you do a live stream. I'm saying to you people out there. Just make sure you have a camera angle. Make sure the camera's on. It's working order. Make sure the camera lighting system is on, always on. Make sure nothing's going to go wrong. Make sure the audio's okay. Like, give thumbs up. And, yeah, just all around give thumbs up. If audio's okay, the camera's okay, the lighting system okay, then go ahead. And if you want to practice beforehand, before you go to live stream, before you start, doing your live stream, just practice it beforehand. Say, just do a little practice run. That's what I do sometimes. I do a practice run on a live stream. I know I like doing it, but it really helps out. Really helps out what you're going to say, what you're going to do on a live stream. Because people don't know what you're going to do on a live stream. I don't want to tell you guys the percentage, but 99% of the time, it's basically good lighting, good camera angles, good audio proportion. So just bear that in mind, folks. So this, I'm going to title this Bloopers, Outtakes, and Raw Audio, Raw Footage. Raw footage is raw footage. It's not edited at all. It's like, I usually say to people, when it comes from the, when the footage comes right off the camera lens to the video recording device, then that's raw footage. That's raw footage. Never been edited ever. No stuff was taken away from the footage, from the camera lens, from the record, when you push the record button, that's raw footage. As soon as it hits the record button. That's just raw audio, raw footage. Raw video. They call it raw video, and for good reason. It's not been edited, not been tampered with, as they say. It's raw audio, right from the camera lens, right from the recording device. Yeah, that's raw audio. It's at its purest. And that's really good sometimes. When raw footage, it's like no one's edited off a computer or the camera footage. It's really odd. Right from the beginning and end. From the beginning and end. That's the raw footage. So folks, bear this in mind. When you're starting your live streams, make sure you have a check mark on the check boxes. And your live stream will go great. It'll go smoothly. Without a hitch. And I would advise you guys, so if you're doing a live stream, keep this in mind. Keep this very much in mind when you're doing live streams. Practice it beforehand. I know I'm telling people it's a little tedious, but you'll get the hang of it. You'll get the hang of it. In time, you'll get the hang of it. Making sure everything's in good working order. Make sure there's no glitches in the streams. Make sure there's good audio, good camera lighting system, good cameras. So this is what I'm hammering with you people out there. And live streams, you can do a live stream, folks. I'm just saying, make sure you have good camera angles, good camera lighting, to good audioing. You can use a mixing board, a mixing console. If you want good audio, you can go with a mixing board. So there you go, folks. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this. This is Dave's podcast. Once again, a day in a life of me talking about any subject that I want to feel freely about. I talk about everything and everything out there. I want to talk freely about you people out there and get you guys entertained and probably listen to what I gotta say. And I'm gonna say it often. I'm gonna use that freedom of speech thing right here on this podcast. And so all you Americans out there, you guys use the First Amendments, I'm hearing. And to the Constitution thing. But here in Canada, we got something called, I think something about rights. I think we have, media rights. They call them media rights. Well, we have Canadian. We have the Canadian laws, not the American laws, but the Canadian laws. American laws, if you're a photographer, they call these people photographers. They can film anywhere on the sidewalks. People have known this for a very long time. As long as you're on a sidewalk, you can film anything. Anything that the person can see. If you're a photographer, that's great, because you can learn the skills of using a camera. That's your best days of learning using a camera, I'm telling you, folks. The United States, they use the First Amendment audits. They'll say in the titles, the subtitles on YouTube videos. So these are just audit. People like to do audit videos. It's like media wants to do a story, a different story. These are people from the media that want to do a story. They're independent journalism. And they want to do a story on anything and anything. They can do it from the camera angles. They usually say, what my eyes see, I'll film, kind of thing, mentality. And that's the United States. That's from the First Amendments to your Constitution. People who are living in the United States. That's the rights you have as a photographer. But when it comes to Canadian rights, you're allowed to do basically some things, but not all. But yeah, if you're a freelance photographer, you have basically few rights of being a photographer, filming anything and everything. But if you're living in the United States, you guys got the First Amendment's rights of filming anything from the sidewalks. That's right, it's public sidewalks versus private property. Did I say more? With public sidewalks, you can film anything your heart desires. Just remember, it's basically when you're on a sidewalk, it's public sidewalk. When you're in somebody's private property, you're not allowed to do that. That's kind of like the gray area. But when it comes to sidewalks are deemed to be public sidewalks. So you can film anything and anything. All bets are off kind of thing. So yeah, that's your First Amendment audits videos. And these are media people. These are, they want to do independent media. As some media that they do. These are just freelance photographers. These are like freelance photographers. And so they can film anything from the sidewalks. So that's the freedom they get in the United States. If you want to become a photographer, go try it. And it's good. It's really good. It's really healthy. There's a few of them on YouTube that do that sort of thing. But not everybody does it. These are just warriors. These are people really, really are warriors out there. They're really showing their grit. They're really showing their grit, and they're doing it for the rest of us out there. They like to do it. You have to have some street smarts too as well. So when you're filming from the streets area, from the sidewalks, you can make sure you have some street smarts. Always remember that. So there you go, folks. Keep happy, keep safe out there, keep what you're doing, and keep doing, and oh, by the way, before I forget, photography is not a crime. Just so you know, folks, photography is not a crime. Okay, that's the one thing on this world that is not a crime, is photographies and cameras. Cameras are not a crime to film anything. You might hear it from the United States about that one. Photography is not a crime. They do mean that, okay? That's the only thing in the world is not a crime, that cameras are not a crime with. It's a tool. Camera is just a tool. Remember that. Camera is just a tool. It's not a weapon, it's not a knife, it's not a gun, it's not any of those things. So a camera is just a camera, it takes footage. That's what it does, that's the tool that the camera does. And it films, that's all its functionality. It's a camera, it films anything and everything. And yeah, you could do that. So bear this in mind, in the world today, a camera's not, photography is not a crime. You might hear it on some of the YouTube videos, of a lot of other people's YouTube videos. Yeah, photography is not a crime, everybody, just so you know that. And you can film from the sidewalks if you're from the United States. filming from the streets, from the sidewalks areas. But you could do that. The police ever, the police people in the United States do tell you that. You can film as much as you want from the sidewalks. The public sidewalks are not, you know, it's not government money or any of those things. And yeah, you could do that. You could be like a free, you could be independent journalism. You could be that independent journalism. You want to do a story. Remember, you always want to do a story. And you can say to the people that you're saying, you're independent journalism. I want to do a story on something. Yeah, just, that's great. That's great for everybody out there who wants to take up photography in the world. And just say you're independent journalism. You're filming from the United States and you're allowed to film on the street because the street is public. Remember, everybody, sidewalks are, they really mean they're public. That's what they really mean. So you can film from the sidewalks. You're allowed to do that. Because sidewalks are public. It's not like you go to a private property. You can't really do that. That's where the law states you can't go on private property and film there. You can film it off a sidewalk series because that's public sidewalks. Anybody can walk on a public sidewalk and film anywhere there. So bear that in mind, folks. You got the First Amendment from the United States. And you got the Constitution. Apparently there's 14 amendments. There's about 14 amendments. Constitution, I think there's about a few of them. So yeah, bear this in mind. If you live in the United States, you have the right to do that. So remember, photography is not a crime. Bear that in mind. Just like I'm saying to everybody out there. So this is the advice what I'm giving to you guys out there. If you want to become independent journalism, that's right. Independent journalism, remember these sort of things. So, and let people know that. Let people know that, that you're independent journalism and you want to do a story on something. Let them know that because they don't know what you're doing.